Hola, hola. My name is Ramon, cosmetic formulator, esthetician, former Sephora employee, and avid skincare consumer. And it is that time of the year. We're getting close to the new year, which means not only holiday season shopping, gift buying for friends and loved ones, but also it's time for the fall Sephora sale. So we're gonna be doing a video today talking about what skincare items at Sephora I actually really enjoy, really recommend, would actually warrant purchasing potentially based on different skincare concerns or wants or what your target gift recipient is into. I'm gonna be organizing this by brand. So in the little time slide below, I'm gonna have the different timestamps for the different brands. I'm gonna be talking individual skincare products, gift sets, because who doesn't love a good little gift set? And realistically, we're gonna be touching on a lot of skincare items. So hopefully you'll be finding something, a set of things that fits your needs. Also for each individual product, I'll be mentioning what skincare concerns and skin types they're best suited for. So with that, let's get into it. First brand we're starting with is Glow Recipe. We all know I love Glow Recipe. They take really cute packaging, really great sensorial and textorial experiences, as well as like really effective skincare items and combine it all together. So I honestly find that like it's a really great brand to get people into skincare in the first place. Some of my favorite product highlights from Glow Recipe, first and foremost, their Papaya Cleansing Balm. This one is pretty much good for everyone. It's a straight to the point cleansing balm. I would target this more for the person who wears a lot of sunscreen, a lot of makeup, or potentially has more oily skin just because it's a really good option for a first cleanse. You get really, really, really gentle exfoliation out of this with from papaya enzymes, but you're really not getting like a lot of that benefit. So it is good for a more sensitive skin type as well. Next up, I have their Guava Vitamin C Dark Spot Treatment Serum. And this is just that, a serum that specifically targets dark spots, acne scars, hyperpigmentation, any discoloration of the skin. It's a really nice, lightweight, gentle version of that serum. It does have 5 different types of vitamin C, but I think it's still a really good option for someone who might have more sensitive skin. But this is really for that person who's targeting dark spots. Great for all skin types though. Next we have their Watermelon Mist. This one is just like a cult standard, like all around great product. It's just a really hydrating mist. It's dual face, so it actually does a little bit more than just simply hydrate. I find it to be really, really nourishing to the skin. It has that really great watermelon scent that's like present in all their watermelon products. And I think this is the best product if you're looking for a really fun skincare product that's great for a very general audience. And last one is their Plum Plump Serum. Specifically though, their new jumbo size, just because you're getting a lot of bang for your buck. And again, this is a hydrating serum. It is pricey, but to me, it just hydrates in a way no other product really does. Great for everyone. Specifically though, I think it's a good option if you have normal skin, dehydrated skin, or dry skin. If you want a little sampling of all these, they have their Fruit Babies Bestseller Kit, which is literally a mini of all their bestsellers. And most of these are on there. I think it's a really good option, especially for someone who travels a lot. But if you want to get the whole collection, all full size, I believe, they also have their Glow Fruit Bar Vault sets. This is a $250 set, but the whole set actually is valued at $356, so you're saving a good amount of money. Overall, Glow Recipe is just a fun brand. Next up from the Inky List, this is the budget-friendly brand. If you are in a pinch and you want to get a lot of things for someone, a few things, and have it be like a more sizable gift, this is the brand you want to go for. Standout products, obviously their Oat Cleansing Balm, which is a first cleanse. This is a very rich cleansing balm. It's one that is great for dry skin, honestly, just because it has that rich, moisturizing, nourishing texture. Every skin type benefits from it though, even me having oily, acne-prone skin, just because it's an oil cleanser. It's gonna break down sebum, makeup, sunscreen, wash it all away, and then you can go in afterwards with anything else. Very general audience skincare product. Next, for the oily, acne-prone individuals, their Salicylic Acid Cleanser. This is just a really great gel cleanser. It's a gentle way to get that salicylic acid exfoliation. You can leave it on for a minute or so to really get a little bit more of that benefit, but it still will be gentle because it is a wash off. For everyone, a really good serum option for hydration is their Hyaluronic Acid Serum. It's very straight to the point. It's a very tiny bottle is my only con with that one. I wish I had a bigger size with it, but Hyaluronic Acid's a good straight to the point hydrator. Everyone benefits from this, especially normal, dehydrated, more dry skin. You can really layer this up, and because it's a really affordable product, it's not breaking the bank. For those individuals, once again, suffering from hyperpigmentation, acne scarring, discoloration and whatnot, their Tranexamic Acid Serum is really, really useful. It's a much more cost-effective version than the Glow Recipe Guava one, if that's something that fancies you, although this one just only features Tranexamic Acid. That one features a cocktail of some other ingredients as well. This one, straight to the point, great for everyone, I think. Really gentle formulation because there's not a lot of bells and whistles in it. This one, I think, is great for everyone, better for more dry skin. Their Peptide Moisturizer, which is also great for anyone who anti-aging is a focus for. This is one I would definitely get my mom. A gel cream moisturizer. It has peptides, so it focuses more on that anti-aging side of skincare. It's very affordable. So this is a good dupe for like some more high-end peptide-based moisturizers, Drunk Elephant. So if you want to get the Drunk Elephant Proteini, this is a great dupe for that. Definitely recommend this one a lot more. Next, we have Murad. Murad is a really great line with a really high price point, but a lot of the products actually kind of warrant it. I think they do a lot of interesting things with formulation. So a lot of what the price point is kind of paying for like the research or the innovation in the actual skincare products. First of all, their entire like blue line, their acne focus line, is amazing. That is one I used religiously for a very long time. Specifically, I'm going to call out their acne control clarifying cleanser. I believe it's the cream version. This one is a salicylic acid based cleanser. It has two different kinds of salicylic acid, regular and encapsulated. So you get a more immediate effect as well as a little bit more of a slower, more gentler effect with the encapsulated salicylic acid. Hydrating, it's nicely nourishing. It's not too stripping. It is pricier, but I think it's a really good investment for individuals who have dry skin but have acne, because I feel like a lot of skincare doesn't cater to that specific audience. If you have dark skin and you want a mineral sunscreen, one of the very, very few options that I can actually attest and have seen applied on deep skin that works amazingly is their City Skin Age Defense Broad Spectrum SPF 50 PA 4+. This is $65. It's not cheap, but if you can get this on sale for the Sephora sale now, this is an amazing deal, or not amazing deal. This is a really great option. Latif Saka, a really good friend of mine who does a lot of sunscreen content, he lives for their sunscreen. It's one of the few mineral sunscreens he really recommends avidly. And then last one from them is their Vitamin C Glycolic Brightening Serum. They have a lot of innovations around their vitamin C to make it very stable and very gentle at a more moderate pH formula for the skin. It's also coupled with glycolic acid, so you're getting vitamin C brightening benefits as well as glycolic acid exfoliation benefits. So you're also getting some antioxidants, some anti-aging benefits from this as well due to some collagen synthesis that both ingredients have. It's not cheap, so again, getting anything from Murad, if you can, get it on sale now for the Sephora sale. They do also have an acne control 30-day trial kit, $36 set that's valued at $53, and it features the cleanser I mentioned as well as some other like really nice things from Murad. Next up is Shiseido. It's another luxe brand, Japanese beauty. Shiseido is also a really cool brand for innovation around formulation. They have a lot of money for research, and Shiseido can be pricey, but with Sephora sale, this is the time to get them and get a few of them if you can. One of the more cheaper options from Shiseido though is their facial cotton. When I worked there, one of the early things that I caught on to was that people were obsessed with their facial like cotton pads. Never understood why people would come in and buy them in bulk, and we always sold out. They're just really good quality cotton pads. You get a like set that's like this big. I forget how much is in them. I recommend any and all Shiseido SPFs. This is a time to get them. They have their little stick SPF, which is a little bit more affordable, but they also have like their Ultimate Sun Protector Lotion and a bunch of their other ones, like their waterproof ones. They range between like 40 to 50, I believe. Getting them on sale gets them down into like the high 20s, 30 range. If you were looking for a really good sunscreen or want to get a few different ones, Shiseido is one of my favorite brands for sunscreens at Sephora. Get them on sale. Shiseido, the cleansing oil, moderately priced cleansing oil. It's actually not that expensive. Not too rich. It's definitely a really good texture. Cleansing oil, great for every skin type. One of the products that got me hooked onto Shiseido, this one is specifically for more oily skin. It's their Essential Energy Moisturizing Gel Cream. It is pricey. It's a splurge, but Shiseido to me is like luxury and like really investing in like self-care. This is one I would only ever buy on sale. I got it for free when I worked there. That was the only reason I really loved it, but a really great moisturizer. And obviously their Ultimmune Power Serum. I've talked about that one on my channel quite a few times recently, and that's just a really great antioxidant serum. It's lightly hydrating. There's a lot of innovation in that formulation as well, and that one's great for everyone, but depends on like what your concern is. Is it anti-aging? Are you looking for something really hydrating for the daytime underneath sunscreen? I have oily skin. I love it just for the texture because it's super lightweight. And then with this one, you also get a few different size options. So depending on what size you want, how much it is, get it on sale for sure. But you have some options as well. This one for me is just like the epitome of luxury from Shiseido though, because it feels very luxurious because it is very heavy. And they do also have a really good value set. It's a Bestsellers Urban SPF set for $48, valued at $94. So what's that, like almost half off? That features a mini of the Ultimmune Serum with some other Shiseido faves. And then they also have an Ultimmune Ritual Mini Set, which features a bigger mini sample size of the Ultimmune with some other stuff as well. Next, I have You To The People, a brand that I've used only a couple of products. I haven't used a lot from the line, but they recently launched a Mandelic Acid Exfoliant that I think is a really great option from the brand. I mean, a lot of people really resonate with You To The People's like message and whatnot. That's nice. But in terms of skincare, I think this is a really cool launch because there's not a lot like this at Sephora. So when I was like looking through at what I thought was a really good option for what to recommend, I was looking at what is also more unique. And this to me really stood out because I don't see Mandelic Acid frequently in Sephora products. This also features like their superfood complex or whatnot. This is a great product for, again, dry skin with acne, even oily skin with acne, or those who are looking to get into exfoliants and might have more sensitive skin just because you have Mandelic Acid, which is a more gentle exfoliant. This is a really good starter exfoliant if you're looking for that, or if you have someone who wants to get into exfoliation. foundation. Next up, we have Fenty Skin, and this is for, honestly, in my mind, Fenty Skin's for everyone, but do note, their products do have fragrance. If the person that you're shopping for or yourself even have sensitive skin, might not be the best option, but their Fat Water is one of my favorite toners for oily, acne-prone skin. Their Hydravisor is a great SPF that I recommend only for primarily normal to dry skin. It is very, very radiant, but if the person that you're shopping for or yourself really enjoy Fenty makeup, the Hydravisor pairs incredibly with their makeup. Can't explain it, but obviously being Fenty, it's gonna work with the entire Fenty lineup. And then their hand mask, their newest launch, their hand mask is interesting. Everyone thought it was a hand cream. It's not. It is a hand mask. It smells like their sunscreen. It's very nicely fragranced. What I appreciate about it is the fact that it is not greasy, even though it is meant to be a very occlusive hand mask. I mean, it has that feel that it's greasy when you like touch other things, but on your hands, it feels very silky, very silicone-y, very soft. All these have really great smells, which is what I love the most about Fenty. So the person you're shopping for is all about self-care, Fenty Skin. They do also have a travel size starter set for $40, and that features minis of their first three launches, their toner, their cleanser, and their sunscreen. And then they have their Before Bed three-piece PM Essentials. This one's a $59 set valued at $69.50. And it has the Fat Water I mentioned, their Overnight Recovery Gel Cream, so like their night moisturizer, and then their Lip Balm, so it can get you nice and prepped for bedtime. Next up, another Black-owned brand. This one's called Topicals, and Topicals had a huge year this year. They're super, super popular in like the Black Twitter sphere, and I've seen a lot of growth from the brand as a result of that. Their two first products were their Faded and their Butter. Faded specifically targets hyperpigmentation, acne scars, discoloration, melasma. That has rave reviews. I've heard nothing but amazing things about it. Smells horribly. Everyone says that. My boyfriend says it smells like expired Nair. And then their buttercream is for people who have very, very dry skin, eczema even. I've seen a lot of people who have eczema like rave about this product. And then this year, they also launched body versions of those in mist format. So you have a faded mist and then you have a butter mist. So if you have pigmentation related issues anywhere on the body, you have the faded products. If you have really, really dry skin or you're prone to eczema, the butter products are what you're looking for. Another new launch from a smaller brand as well, we have Tower 28. They recently launched a tinted sunscreen, their Sunny Day Tinted SPF. This is an interesting product. It is a tinted SPF foundation, so it kind of treads that line between the two things. What is really a big standout of this is a tinted sunscreen that comes in 28 shades. It has a very wide shade range. What's really cool about this is that this is really catering to fair skin, but also very deep skin. I've seen nothing but amazing application footage all across the like shade spectrum. The only caveat is that A, it is technically a foundation, so there is coverage to it. So I know people who don't like makeup that are like, this is more makeup adjacent, and I don't know how I feel about that. But also it's 30 mil for $30. So if you're interested in trying it out, I would recommend getting it on sale now for the Sephora sale. Next, from First Aid Beauty, I have arguably, I think, one of their most popular products I've seen this year. I have their Keratosis Polaris, KP, Bump Eraser Body Scrub with 10% AHA. Keratosis Polaris, aka chicken skin, is a problem a lot of people have, actually. I've seen a good amount of body care, I feel like, this year come out specifically targeting that. This is one of the products I've seen the best reviews of, though. Also, one of my favorite products from them is their Facial Radiance Pads. For me, it really helps with my acne, but also anyone who has texture issues or they have pigmentation related issues or they want to get into exfoliation. These are a really great option because they're very gentle on the skin and you can get a lot of bang for your buck with these. I always recommend cutting them in half because you don't need a whole pad for your face and a little bit goes a long way. And then I have two dandruff focused items, and this is interesting because I mean, everyone's used to Head and Shoulders, but if you are, for example, sensitive to that product, there's not a lot of like dandruff related products at Sephora, but these are ones I see a lot and heard a lot of reviews about. You have their anti-dandruff scalp serum with 2% salicylic acid, as well as their anti-dandruff shampoo with 1% pyrithione zinc, ZPT. The scalp serum, I think, is a really good option as like a pre-treatment for like when you're starting to wash your hair. And then you have the actual shampoo with the pyrithione zinc. One or the other, I think if dandruff's been concerned, start with the actual shampoo. And then if that doesn't work, maybe get the serum as well. Salicylic acid, though, is really great for targeting very, very oily scalp. Pyrithione zinc specifically is an antifungal ingredient that targets the cause of dandruff. So if you have a more mild case, maybe moderate case, this is a really useful shampoo to have. In terms of gift sets, you have the Your Future Looks Fab gift set. That's a $49 set that is valued at $112. So that is actually a really good discount. That comes with the KP Bump Body Scrub, as well as the Facial Radiance Pads. Then you have their First Aid Beauty Faves To Go Kit. That's a $30 set valued at $45 that features the Facial Radiance Pads. If you want to step up and level up the exfoliation pads, though, from Dr. Dennis Gross, I just literally put here peel pads, period. All their pads are really good. They're like these double set exfoliating wipes, essentially. And one of them is the exfoliation pads. The other one's like a neutralizer. And you have like the standard one, a more sensitive skin one, a really intense one. You have like a retinol version. And then now they have body versions as well for the exfoliation pads. So depending on where you are and like your exfoliation journey, you have a lot of good options. I started using, I think, the regular pads and saw a really good success with those. They really helped with a lot of texture and acne-related issues. If you can tolerate them, they have the intense version, which are very spicy. I definitely had to work up to those. It's not the most environmentally sound concept, but it's a very convenient thing to just open up a little pad, wipe it, wipe, you're done. The peel pads, again, great for acne, great for texture, pigmentation, anti-aging, because they're a little bit more of the stronger alpha hydroxy acids. And then next, another mineral sunscreen option, all physical lightweight wrinkle defense broad spectrum SPF 30 from Dr. Dennis Gross. Mineral sunscreen that's, for the most part, I think a really good option for even darker skin tones. It is a $42 sunscreen, so I do recommend that one for the sale specifically, just because it is pricey for not a lot of product. I think it's still like 50 mil, but it's a mineral sunscreen I've heard a lot of great things about. Get it while it's cheap. They do have a gift set that features three of the pads I really like. It's the Peel Love Joy gift set. That one's $34 for a $51 value, so pretty good deal with that one. And then they also have the Peel and Protect set that is $18. You get the high strength of the peel pads, and then you also get the SPF as well. So that one, again, really good little mini set specifically for like pigmentation or like anti-aging. Next is a brand called Carez. Carez is a Greek beauty brand, and they are the clean beauty brand that to me just gets slept on. I love their products. The Greek yogurt cleanser, great for everyone. A really nice foaming cleanser. It's not stripping to the skin, it's still nicely hydrating. It's a good all-around bet. And then their Greek yogurt moisture cream, it's rich. It's not like really occlusive, but it's not a super lightweight gel. If you have dry skin, it's a really nice day option as well, I find. And I think with the Greek yogurt line, it's hydrating, but it's also really just nourishing. You also have their Wild Rose Spotless Serum with 15% vitamin super C. This is a really nice serum if you want either pigmentation fighting benefits or antioxidant benefits during the daytime, and you have more gentle skin, more sensitive skin, I mean, in my opinion. It treads the line between being like a serum and like a really oddly like lightweight moisturizing product. It is very runny, but it has a little bit of like a richness to it. Still great for all skin types. If you have more oily skin, I would use this as a moisturizer underneath my sunscreen. Like, that's it. If you have dry skin, layer this, but it's a really great product that helps to like kickstart the moisturizing process. In terms of gift sets from Carez, you have the Grecian Glow Skincare Rituals gift set, which is a $38 set valued at $68, so pretty good deal. And that features the cleanser as well as some other favorites from Carez. And next we have Sunday Riley. And Sunday Riley is actually one of my favorite skincare brands at Sephora, but the issue is they are expensive. So I generally only recommend getting their products when there is a sale. Favorite product from them, the UFO Oil, the Ultra Clarifying Facial Oil. This is everything if you have oily, acne-prone skin. It prevents breakouts, treats breakouts, and then helps with the pigmentation problems after breakouts. It is a treatment oil, but it's intended for oily skin. It just smells really good too. I love the scent of it. You get two sizes of this. There's a $40 one and then an $80 one. The thing is with this is the $40 one lasts me a really long time. So the $80 one's expensive, but realistically get the $40 one because the $40 one lasted me an entire year with really frequent use. And because it is a treatment oil, I don't recommend using it every single day. You can use it by itself, pat it in, mix it into like a moisturizer or something. They recommend mixing it into foundations. I've done that and I feel like it oxidizes my foundation a little bit or like darkens it, so don't do that. And then next you have their Saturn Sulfur Spot Treatment Mask. It's a sulfur-based product that's intended for oily, acne-prone skin. You can use this as a treatment on actual breakouts or use it as like an overall treatment on areas where you get like congestion or you're really oily normally. This, in my opinion, is a great option for someone who is sensitive to salicylic acid because, again, it's sulfur-based. It has some clays and things like tea tree to help target breakout-prone skin. So you don't have to wait for a sale to get this one. It's a great option year-round, but this is a great gift for oily, acne-prone skin individuals. And then last from them is their Tidal Water Enzyme Cream. This is the product that I really love, and I hate to love it because it is really expensive for a moisturizer. I believe it's like $65. And it basically is like a really lightweight gel cream, so it's perfect for oily, acne-prone skin that features enzymatic exfoliants, really gentle exfoliants. So it's great if you have like pigmentation or texture issues. I love this product. I love the texture and the feel of it on the skin. It's just so expensive, so I only ever buy it when there's a sale. Gift sets. You have their Go to Bed With Me Complete Anti-Aging gift set, so someone who's looking at anti-aging benefits. It's a $93 gift set, but it's valued at $193, so good deal, but I would still only get this on a sale. And then you have their All About Acne Breakout and Blackhead set. Again, this one's a $95 gift set, but valued at $163. This one features Saturn and UFO, which I talked about, as well as some of their other products from their acne focused line. Get this on sale. Next, I have Innisfree, which Innisfree is one of the only Korean brands sold at Sephora right now. Back in my day when I first got hired, there was a bunch of them. With this one specifically, they have really good, very cost-effective sunscreens. There's their Daily UV Defense Sunscreen SPF 36, $15. And then their Matte Priming Daily UV Defense Defense Sunscreen SPF 37, $18. Obviously the first one, more general, but it's gonna be a little bit more radiant. Their matte priming one is great for oily skin because obviously it is more mattifying. In terms of white casts, none of them should, but the matte one has silica, which I know for deeper skin tones can kind of be a little bit of an issue. Swatch it while you're in store though, if you can. And then also from them, I have their Fermented Soybean Essence. I love me a good essence. In my mind, I thought they were cost effective. This one's $39, so I would only get this one if it was on sale, but it's hard to find a cheap essence at Sephora nowadays, just because aside from Innisfree, you have Amore Pacific and Shiseido and Sulwhasoo, and all those are more like luxury Korean brands. So it's a good option. Get this on sale, it'll be like $20-something. Next is Herbivore. Love Herbivore. Soft spot in my heart for Herbivore because they're both Seattle-based. I discovered a lot of their stuff when they were sold at like smaller boutiques, and then they got put into Sephora, so I feel like I discovered them when they were still indie. Their oils are everything to me. Their oils are also super expensive. They're like $80+, so I would only ever get them on sale, but they last you for forever. Their Phoenix oil is great for everyone, but if you have dry skin, best option. Their Lapis oil, best for oily, acne-prone skin. And then their Orchid oil, another all-around option, but it's a richer oil still. Regardless though, whatever skin type is, I love me a good oil. Pink Cloud Cleanser is one of their cheaper items. Really cute still, very gimmicky because it's like that pink jelly-like situation. Great for teenagers, just because it is cute, very Instagrammable. $24, so it's very cost-effective. Not gonna break the bank. Their Cocoa Rose Exfoliating Body Scrub, good body care, nice little exfoliant for the body. Smells really, really nice, super cute as well. Great for that person who body care is very important for. And for oily, acne-prone skin, their Blue Tansy BHA and Enzyme Pore-Finding Mask. It's a really great treatment mask, but I wouldn't recommend that for dry skin. Gift sets for them, they have the Moment of Clarity Smooth Skin Set, so this is for oily, acne-prone skin. That is a $50 set valued at $81, and it features the Lapis Oil and their Blue Tansy Mask. And then they also have the Moment to Escape Soft Glow Body Sets. That's a $40 set valued at $55. And that one features the Cocoa Rose Body Scrub. Next is Supergoop. And Supergoop is a brand I don't like to talk about a lot on my channel. I think it's really overpriced for what it is. It's like the Whole Foods of Sephora brands in my opinion. But they have this Play SPF, which is a very just like general audience SPF. It's moisturizing, it's kind of radiant. It's not the most oil controlling, so it's not like the one I recommend for oily skin, but it's a great general, everyone can use it sunscreen. They have an 18-ounce jumbo bottle. That's 532 milliliters. That's $58 regular price. And that in itself, I mean, sounds like a lot of money, but think about the amounts per dollar. If you were to like make little 50 ml bottles of that, each 50 ml bottle would be only like $5. So it's a great deal. And then $58 regular price on sale, it'd be like what, $40 steal. It's one of the only Supergoop items I will ever promote. And that's just because you're getting a lot of product for a very small amount of money, get it on sale. And then one of the more innovative items Supergoop actually has, they have these Shimmer Shade Illuminating Cream Eyeshadows that have SPF and then they're SPF 30. They are these tubes, they're like cream shadows. You can use them by themselves as a sheer wash, layer them for like a more opaque wash, or use them as an eyeshadow base, an eye primer. They have SPF in them. And I think that's a really cool concept if really layering SPF is important. Gift sets, they do have the SPF from head to toe kit, the $28 kit valued at $41. And it features the Play as well as some other Supergoop sunscreens. Supergoop doesn't have bad sunscreens. I just think they're really overpriced for what they are. I will say though, their mineral sunscreens, not good. Even their CC one that they were like, it's a broad shade range, not good. And then next from, I think my number one brand from Sephora, Dr. Jart's. This beats Sunday Rally, it beats Fenty Skin. Dr. Jart's is a really great brand for me. They formulate the hell out of a product. I love their entire Cicapair line, all of it, everything from it. Cicapair is all Centella Asiatica based, so it's great if you have very compromised skin, if you have very irritated skin, sensitive skin. It is just a very soothing line. Specific call outs, if you have oily skin, their Tiger Grass Gel Cream. More gel texture. If you have more dry skin, their regular cream, so it's a little bit more of a heavier version of the Cicapair line. Their sleeping mask is everything to me. I use that on a very regular basis. It's a huge tub of it. Little goes a long way. It'll last you a very long time. Their Everyday Sun Fluid. It's just a very standard chemical sunscreen, SPF 50+. I love Dr. Jart sunscreens, but it's just expensive, and I don't love recommending expensive sunscreens. That's why the industry ones are like the ones I will recommend to you. But if you can get it on sale, get it on sale. And then they do have a gift set featuring a bunch of their Cica-based products. It's called their Cica Rescue Kit. It's $42 and it's valued at $71, so decent price. Next, from a brand called Kula, which I don't talk about a lot on my channel because they're a sunscreen brand, but they're like expensive and they're also like a clean brand. It doesn't align with my ethos necessarily, but if you can get it on sale, get it on sale. They have their makeup setting spray, and that's an SPF 30. It's intended to set makeup, make it last longer, give you sunscreen benefits, but it also is intended to like kind of help control shine. So if you have oily skin, this might be a really good option because with a lot of sunscreen sprays, use in mist, they leave you really, really shiny. So if you're looking for an SPF mist to reapply over top of your makeup, or if you just have oily skin in general, get this one from Kula. Get it on sale. Don't pay full price. From Kate Somerville, I love Kate Somerville skincare, but it's expensive. But the product I am willing to splurge on is the Exfoliate Intensive Pore Exfoliating Treatment. And this is everything if you have texture, pigmentation, breakouts. This specifically is a enzymatic and physical exfoliant. It features pineapple, pumpkin, and papaya enzymes, as well as like an actual physical exfoliant texture. This is one I like to apply, kind of like a mask, let it do its thing with the enzymatic exfoliants, and then after a couple minutes, I'll activate it with water and start to work with the physical exfoliation of it. It's just a really cool product. It's really, really nice. It's really expensive. So this is one I really only recommend getting during the VIB sales. They do have a Glow in a Wink Exfoliate bestseller set. This features like the best of the best from the Exfoliate line. And they have like a really cool cleanser and a moisturizer and stuff. That is a $65 set valued at $119. So almost half off of that. Definitely worth getting. Get it on sale. Next from Peter Thomas Roth, another great line that's just a little bit too expensive for me. Their Pumpkin Enzyme Mask. And FYI, when I talk about enzyme exfoliants, they're basically like sister products to like AHAs. So just maybe like a little bit more gentle. And those generally come from fruit. So with this, you have pumpkin, and this also does have a physical benefit to it as well. So this is also like a mask, apply it, let the pumpkin enzymes do their thing, and then activate with water, let the physical exfoliation do its thing. I love a good physical exfoliant, as demonized as they are. I think they're really great ones. This one is expensive. Get it on sale. Definitely worth it though. And then another treatment from them, this is their Therapeutic Sulfur Acne Treatment Mask. This is another sulfur-based treatment. So again, this one's great for oily skin, more acne-prone skin. If you can't tolerate salicylic acid, or you might have more sensitive skin, sulfur is a great treatment. Get this. It's expensive. Get it on sale. Aside from the pumpkin mask I talked about, Peter Thomas Roth is famous for like the other mask in their line as well. And they have a little mini gift set featuring five of them. It's called their Masking Minis 5-Piece Mask Kit. It's a $19 kit, and it's like minis of the masks. And it's a $35 value. And I think it's worth trying out. I think it's really cute. This is a good gift set for someone who likes like the spa treatment and likes a lot of self-care. And then they also have another gift set that features their masks. It's called their Mask to the Max. It's a 4-piece mask kit. It's a $58 kit that's valued at $170 that features more large size. But this one does feature a full size of the pumpkin enzyme mask. Again, great for the person who loves self-care. If you're a gift giver, if you want to splurge, a good option. Not as cute and small as the mini set, but also a great gift option. And with that, that is my skincare recommendations for the Sephora VIB sale slash if you're just shopping for a skincare lover this holiday season. A lot of different options and a lot of great products if you want to just get single-based products based off a person's specific skincare needs, or if you're looking for some gift sets to make skincare buying easy for you. There are a lot of great options at Sephora, a lot of great deals at Sephora. But regardless, stay tuned because I'm gonna have another video talking about what some of my makeup must-haves for this holiday season are, as well as what my non-skincare makeup beauty favorites are this year as well. So I have those as separate videos. So subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you know when those go live. Down below in the comment section, let me know what are some of the skincare items you're gonna try to grab for the VIB sale this year, slash let me know what some of the skincare items you're hoping that you're gonna get gifted this holiday season. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up, and thanks for watching, guys. Bye.